Hi and welcome! In this video tutorial, you will learn the basic logic of the EMS-4 display with a practical example. In this video, we only look at the general handling and do not go into any concrete operating screens. Here, you can see the EMS-4 display with the tower crane operating system. At the top is the status bar. You'll see the diagnostic messages in the left corner. To the right of it, you can see the current operating information. An explanation of all symbols can be found in the operator's manual. In the right corner, you can see the time and date. In the middle, you see the split screen. You can display different crane data at the top and bottom. Just change the screens as you please. At the bottom of the screen, you see the main menu. You see the icons for home, user settings, crane settings and service info. In the right bottom corner, you can see other icons such as the camera, the quick access menu and the clear button, which acknowledges messages and silences audible warning sounds. Now that you have a general idea of the display, you will learn to find your way around the menu, call up the individual page ID of each screen and read the diagnostic messages. Whenever a screen has multiple bars at the top, you can swipe to see more pages. In the upper half, you will see a small arrow. Here, you can use the extension menu to activate other options, such as the camera. In the split screen, you can put together the operating images as you wish to make all the necessary information visible. Right now, we are in the home operating screen. When you call up another menu item, a submenu will appear on the left-hand side. The active topic has a little blue line on the right side. When you select the topic, a second submenu might appear. From top to bottom, you can now select the submenu items. You can use the quick access to change the display brightness and volume. You can switch between day and night mode. You can lock the display for 15 seconds to clean it. You can activate cabin and construction site lighting. Here you can display a QR code with which you can download the operating instructions to your smartphone. Particularly important is the display of the page ID in the quick access menu. If you provide this number, Liebherr Support will immediately know the exact page you are looking at. Each mask in the display has an individual number. The number you see in the quick access menu is always that of the current mask. The door icon always takes you one step back. You can use the speech bubble in the left corner to display all diagnostic messages from the system. You can filter between error, warning, and info messages. Old messages don't disappear, they turn gray. Press the arrow next to a message to read the description about it. If you press the clear button at the bottom right corner, all resolved messages will be marked as red. Use the clear button wisely and read all the warnings. Things to remember. The menu navigation runs from left to right in the main menu, in the two submenus from top to bottom. Do you see bars at the top? Then you can swipe. In the quick access menu, you find the page ID. The door icon will always take you one step back. You find diagnostic messages here. Good job! Now you know your way around in the menu. You can call up the page ID of each page and read the diagnostic messages. Congratulations on your new knowledge about the EMS-4 and TCOS.